So that the Sahaba radiallahu alayhim, many of them, they used to say, we used to follow Hudayfa. If someone dies in Medina, we would follow Hudayfa. If Hudayfa prays on him, then we pray. If Hudayfa doesn't pray, then we know he's, huh? Good question, Ma'a Sunnah. Yeah. Subhanallah. So much that Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, Sayyidina Umar came to Hudayfa radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, and he told him, yeah, when Sayyidina Umar became the Khalifa, of course, as you know, Umar. If he tells you to do something, you better do it right away. One time, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari came and knocked, and then knocked twice, and then he left. Sayyidina Umar did not open the door, he was busy. He told the people, who knocked on the door? They said, Abu Musa, where is he? He's gone. He says, if he does not bring me a hadith that he left, because I didn't open for him right away, then I will whip him tonight in front of everybody. Abu Musa, he heard the news, now he's running in Medina. Please, have you heard this hadith? He got few people together, huh? They said, yes, if we knock three times on, then you go back, no problem. He said, okay, you're off the hook. Now, anyway, subhanAllah, Sayyidina Umar told him, Ya Hudayfa, come here. I know that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave you that secret. I am going to ask you one question. Is my name among them? SubhanAllah. Look at us, you know, pray five times, have a little beard, and have tasbih, and now we're thinking we have a green card to Jannah. Straight. Huh? الإنسان مغرور. This little things, changing the words. يعني yesterday we were this, today we're this. Now yesterday we were high, today we're saying Assalamu alaikum. After a few days, now we're giving people Jannah and Nar. We assign people to Jannah and Jahannam. Right away. Now, it takes a couple of weeks only. A couple of weeks of change. And then we start assigning, not only assigning ourselves. No, we already guaranteed. Then we assign people, he is going to Jannah, walayyadu billah, he is going to Jahannam, he is, هذا مبتدع, هذا فاسد, هذا ضال, هذا مشرك. By the way, notice. Why? جهل. الجهل. Ignorance and arrogance, walayyadu billah. And these are the problems of Iblis, لعائل الله عليه. Iblis was also ignorant and arrogant. And that's how people are. They know little things. And that's why, Sayyid Abbas al-Maliki, the son of, or the father of Sayyid Muhammad Alawi that passed away of Mecca, the Muhaddith of Mecca, rahmatullahi alayh, he says, those who know more, object less. And those who know less, object more. The less you know, the more you object. Everybody is kafir to you. Everybody is mushrik muqtadi, waliyadu billah. Anyway, Umar radiallahu anhu says, Ya Hudayfa, tell me, is my name among them? Hudayfa looks, he says, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, your name is not among them, and I will not answer anyone after you. That's it. هذا حذيفة رضي الله عليه used to sit behind the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Look at this man. Look at the geniusness of some. These Sahabis are unbelievable. Sometimes they say, where were they educated? What kind of knowledge was given to them? What kind of elite schools did they attend? They attended a university called Muhammad Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And what a university of it is. The best that there is. Hudayfa used to say, I used to sit behind Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and I watch people coming and asking him for things. For good things to do. People come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, what's the good thing to do today? What should I do? What is the best of the deed? You all know the hadith. He says, and I wait and I ask him for the bad things to avoid. They ask him for good things, and I ask him about bad things. Because if I know the bad things, I can avoid them. But if I don't know the bad things, I cannot avoid them. Notice. Hudayfa says, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كَانَ فِي مَنْ قَبْلَكُمْ رَجُلْ There was a man before you. This man, أَتَاهُ الْمَلَكُ لِيَقْبِضَ رُوحَهُ الحديث says, hadith al-Bukhari again. The angel came, again we said the angel came to take, I didn't say Israel, notice. The reason for that is yes, while the name of Israel is very famous and widespread, but there is no authentic narration that says Malakul Maut is specifically Israel. Notice. While it could be, I'm not saying it's totally false. I'm just saying there's no authentic evidence that his name is Israel, number one. Number two, Malakul Maut is not only one. تَتَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَ Angels, actually. الملك, the angel of the of death came ليقبض روحه, to take his soul. So he took his soul, and then he was asked, did you have you done anything good? عملت خير؟ عملت خير؟ Anything good that you've done in your life? He said, I don't know. People who do have not done good, what do they say? They're not going to say no right away, huh? They're going to, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. Well, you know, اقرأ كتابك. You'll have your book right in front of you. Then the hadith says, قيل له انظر. Then the malaika would tell him, okay, look, here's your book now. Look in your book, see what you have, whether you have done any good in your life. He looks, he says, no. But there's one thing, I had a habit. Huh? I had a habit. انظروا, I was in the dunya, I was a businessman. انظروا المؤثر وأتجاوزوا الموسر وأتجاوزوا عن المؤثر. In the dunya, when I was a businessman, when people deal with me, I deal with them with simplicity and open-mindedness and generosity. If one has a lot of money, if he's rich, then I give him time to pay me. And if one is poor, then I just forgive him. And the hadith says, فَأَدْخَلَهُ اللَّهُ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to go to Jannah. Because, why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deals with you, huh, like you deal with his creation. What do I mean by that? بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. You all know the hadith of البخاري. من لم يرحم لا يرحم. من لا يرحم لا يرحم. Who is not merciful with the slaves of Allah, Allah is not merciful with him. الرحمون يرحمهم الرحمن. Those who are merciful, Allah gives them mercy. Notice, if you want to be treated with mercy, then you have to treat the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with mercy as well. Then you have to have that in your heart. Because if you like to be forgiven, you have to learn how to forgive. عباد الله اتقوا الله العظيم حق تقواه وراقبوه مراقبة من يعلم ويعتقد بأنه يراه وتزودوا لدنياكم من دنياكم لآخرتكم عملا يحبه ويرضاه اعلموا أنه لا يضر وينفع ويعطي ويمنع ويصل ويقطع ويخفض ويرفع إلى الله واعلموا أن الله تعالى أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه قال تعالى ولم يزل قائلا عليما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين أعلي مولانا كلمة الحق والدين اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه إليه من أراد بهم غير ذلك فاجعل دائرة السوء عليه اللهم رد المسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا آتي أنفسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ربنا ومولاها صل اللهم مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا فك أسرانا وارحم موتانا صل اللهم لنا ولآبائنا ولمشايخنا ولمن له حق علينا ولمن على الخير أعاننا وعن الشر أبعدنا ولمن أوصانا بالدعاء وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وآله أقيم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله.